What is a small language model?
Small language model is kind of what it sounds like, right? A large language model is trained on a ton of data, often gathered from all over the internet and used for a range of tasks. ChatGPT, people might use it to write Shakespearean sonnets about ice cream, or they might use it to summarize meeting notes, you know, like a very diverse range of tasks that are related to human language. These small models are trained on a much smaller, more refined set of data. And the idea is that for a lot of companies, and let's be clear, companies are really the customers for a lot of these large language models. They're the ones with lots of money, right? And AI companies want them to pay for them. They're going to need them for specific things, and maybe one thing that they are really good at, something related to coding, perhaps, a chatbot that's very focused on tax prep questions, for instance. So the hope by a lot of these companies is that these models will be more energy efficient, and they will be more focused, and they will basically just be more helpful in general.
Who is leading the way in small language models? Kind of seems like an odd question, but every time a very cutting-edge large language model comes out, we cover it as news on the show. Do we have a sense of like who's focused on that area?
Yeah. So we have actually like a pretty big range of companies that are involved in this. There are a couple startups that are very focused on this. I spoke with one called RCAI. They are totally focused on customizing open source small models and customize. So they customize them for customers, including a company called Guild, which used it to make a career coaching chatbot so they could scale up more than they could do with their human career coaches. Sakana AI is a company that's in Japan that's working on this. And then also the big tech companies have increasingly been releasing these small versions of their larger flagship models, like OpenAI recently released 4.0 Mini.